When we talk about Elden Ring PvP, we know that there are things that are considered meta, the most consistently performing weapons, armor, tools at your disposal that you can to defeat enemies. One of my favorite things about Elden Ring is that you can make builds that are off meta and do some pretty interesting things. Today we're going to be talking about Rosu's Axe. Now this thing is a pretty bad weapon. It is not really consistent, it's kind of weird. But it has some unique qualities to it that actually turns it into a one-shotting machine that you may not know exists. Rosu's Axe has a unique special attack that when you hit L2, it summons these little skeleton guys that smack down on the ground. These skeletons are usually not incredible at tracking, they're really not that great at hitting the target, this and that. You summon your skeletons, and it's like, yep, that leads you open to a wide attack, you are definitely open to being hit. But one thing about this special attack that not a lot of people realize is that when you do summon the skeletons and they come swinging down, what's nice is that even if you're staggered out of the initial hit, as long as the skeletons summon and you're staggered and hit, the skeletons will still come swinging down. We run 33 faith for the use of Hallow Shabriri. Now, the reason we do this is because it gives an insane damage increase of 30%. Now, of course, with this also being a intelligence build, we get access to Terra Magica, which is another 20%, I believe 25% damage increase. These two stacking can then create these skeletons that Rosu's Axe summons to do an insane amount of damage. One way our Rosu summons is also going to get a buff is from our armor that we're wearing, which is the full Spellblade outfit. This gives about a 2% damage increase with each piece of the armor that is worn. This doesn't just apply to things like, you know, magic greatsword or something like that with the spell. It also applies to the special on this weapon. So we're pushing damage with those two buffs, Terra Magica and Hallow Shabriri. Then we're getting extra damage buffs with the armor that we're wearing. And then of course, in our Wondrous Flask, we're running magic damage increase. On top of that, here are the talismans that we're running. We're doing Magic Scorpion, which makes you even weaker, and it only pushes your damage slightly, but hey, we're doing off meta today, who cares? We're also doing both Graven School talismans to make sure our magic damage is even higher, and then Shard of Alexander to make sure our special attack does more damage. Now, does this make you a weak little peanut that will be squashed by everyone? Yes, it does, but yeah, we're here to get the one shot. We're here to do some little goofy stuff. Your interactions are gonna go as follows. You buff with Hallow Shabriri, then you do Terra Magica, and as long as you stay within this circle, you have a one-shotting machine. Now, here's the idea. Oh, you're doing a close-range axe weapon, and you have to find someone dumb enough to come in your circle? Yeah, true. But this also kind of plays into the psychology of especially ganking, you know, bonfire duelists, things like that. Everyone just wants the fight, right? What I found is that when I put these two down and I just sit here crouch and wait, yeah, they can't control themselves. They have to go fight you and see what this weird thing that you're doing is. The plan is simple. Invite them into your circle and then start swinging and praying, baby. If all of these skeletons hit, maybe it might not 100% do the job, but a quick slash from the axe afterwards will finish them off. Here that goes.
Outrageous man.